Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On the occasion of completion of 73 years as an independent nation, I, Master Muazzamullah from Madrasatul Suffa, will shed light on some of the sacrifices of Indian Muslims for freeing India from the clutches of British. The invasion of Europeans started with the Portuguese pirates in 17th century. By the name of trade, they kept an eye on the India's wealth and India's land. Slowly but wisely, they started attacking on many of the kingdoms and started their own rules and regulations. The British General Neil, when defeated Tipu Sultan, climbed over his body and shouted, "From today, India is ours." Shah Waliullah Muhaddis Dehlavi was the first person to understand the cunning and threat nature of British. He started spreading awareness among the common people. After his death, his pupil and his children, Shah Abdul Aziz, Maulana Ahmadullah, Haji Imdadullah and Begum Nawab, were the Muslims fighting for Sultan Bahadur Shah Zafar. No matter how much these people fought, the 1857 revolution failed. Then they decided to change up the strategy and put up educational institutions across the country to combat the disastrous British policies. The foremost among them was Maulana Muhammad Qasim Nanotvi, who established Darul Uloom in Deoband to produce a team of ulama to fight against the British government. The Reshmi Rumal movement chalked the first student of Darul Uloom Deoband, Maulana Mahmud Hassan, was to attack the British bases in India with the help of Ottoman Caliphate of Turkey, but all in vain. When the First World War erupted, the Indian subcontinent was resounding with the slogans of Khilafat movement. The Muslim leaders elected Gandhiji as a leader, and in 1919, Jamiat Ulama-e-Hind came to provide a platform to Muslims for fighting against the British. It's worth mentioning that Jamiat taught Congress to follow the path of freedom, and they worked together and adopted a complete freedom program. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad was a hero of India's independence. By his writings and particularly historical newspapers such as Al Hilal and Al Balag, he heated up the Indian subcontinent with the slogans of freedom. The sacrifices that Muslims have offered for freeing India from the British slavery cannot be described in this short speech. Muslims always held high the torch of patriotism and always fight against the British. But today it is tragic that Muslims are blamed that they are traitors. The Muslim fighters, instead of being paid homage, they are removed from the history and textbook. Mentioning these sacrifices in this speech is to remind our brave past. May Allah keep all Indian Muslims safe and prosperous and make this country world's most peaceful country. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh. Jazakallahu khair. Happy Independence Day.